Welcome back to another episode of the Arc Switch Survival Guide. Today we are going to teach you all about remote activation keypads, how to program them, how to build them, and how to use them to remotely control your doors and dinosaur gates on Arc. And most of you who have tamed a big dinosaur in a taming pen know by painful experience that the most dangerous part of any dinosaur tame is actually closing the door. That's the part where you usually get your butt kicked. But after you've finished watching this episode, you will be able to set up a remote activation keypad, and from complete safety, after you get a dinosaur into your dino pen, you can use the remote activation keypad to slam the door shut without being anywhere near the claws or fangs. So this is going to be a very helpful episode for you, and we're going to show you how to set up multiple different doors on different frequencies so you can close and activate separate sections of your dinosaur taming pen. And we'll also show you some other cool things you can do with this remote activation keypad, like setting up all of your lights on the remote keypad so you can turn on and off all of the lights on your base, or set up separate colors and mood lighting that you can control with just a couple of clicks, which will be really helpful, and it's a very good time saver. And another trick we'll show you, which will change your life, is how to set up remotely activated drone guns at outposts around your base. And we can actually control these drone guns from a great distance and clear out all the dangerous dinosaurs in an area without ever having to get close to them, so that they'll be dead by the time we get there, which is really helpful and convenient. Now, I know a lot of you are just here for the guide on how to use a remote activation keypad in Arc, so we'll have a very succinct guide on that at the beginning of this episode, but this is also a Let's Play series, so if you watch until the end of the guide, we'll actually show you how we set up the electrical cables and all of the things that we built to make this guide possible. And if you watch this episode until the end, we'll show you some cool extra structures they added with the Structures Plus update that will allow you to connect electrical cables really easily and efficiently. So stick around for that if you're interested, and I'll put some timestamps in the description so you can jump straight to whichever topic you're interested in if you're in a hurry. So let's get started. Now, the first step in using a remote keypad in Arc is actually reaching level 53 so that you can learn the engram. It's a level 53 engram, and it costs 25 electronics, 1 cementing paste, and 2 metal ingots. What that means is you're going to need a lot of pearls to make these. Now, I've got a couple really helpful guides on how to get lots of pearls very safely and easily, and I'll put some links in the description that you can check out if you want to learn how to get lots of pearls in Arc. And you can also, as of some of the most recent updates, if you're using Arc on a console other than Switch, you can actually loot electronics from tech dinosaurs when you kill those. So hopefully you'll get that update pretty soon if you're playing Arc Switch as well. So we've got all the materials we needed, we just had to craft one more set of electronics in the fabricator, and now we've got our remote keypad made. Now, I've also got a whole guide on how to use a fabricator if you're not familiar with that, and a whole guide on how to set up the electric system we're going to use to power the fabricator. But for the sake of this section, I've already got all of that laid out, and we have an electrical outlet right here. Now, you need to make the remote keypad within about 2 foundations distance of an electric outlet. So keep that in mind, and you are going to want to put that in a place that's close to your taming pen that you can quickly reach it if you've got a dinosaur lured into that taming pen, but you also want it to be somewhere out of reach. You can technically even set it up in the very middle of your taming pen, as long as you don't mind the dino killing you in the process. But I like to find a perch that's really high above my dino taming pen like this, and this will be an ideal location to actually place that remote keypad so I can safely fly up here and be well out of reach, but any dino in the taming pen should still be far enough from the door for me to trap it inside. Now you have to have a vertical surface like a wall in order to place the remote keypad on, and I'm going to set up a little sniping platform here, so after I lure a dinosaur into the taming pen, I will have a spot where I can shoot down on it, get a couple of tranks on it, and keep it aggroed onto this side of the taming pen. So from here, I'll make a little platform, so I've got a clear line of sight to shoot straight down, and this will keep the dino far away from the main front gate that I can activate the remote keypad right away, and it'll be completely trapped. So I'm going to make a wall here on the edge, and that way I can actually mount the keypad. So I'm just going to place a wall down here, and that'll give us a nice vertical surface that we can place our keypad on. Now, just like any structure, we're just going to place the keypad in our inventory, but as you can see, you can only place it on a wall or some kind of vertical structure. So we'll put it there, and as you can see, it's got a cord going all the way to the electrical outlet, and it's all lit up, the lights are on, which means it's working great. Now we can access the menu by pressing X on Switch, triangle on PS4, or Y on Xbox One, and that's going to give us some menu options. Now you can access its inventory because on some maps you can make batteries to power it instead of an electric outlet, but we don't need to worry about that here. The main menu options are going to be up to activate slash open or down to deactivate slash close. And you'll see it lets you set a pin number. Now, we're going to program these in. It's not going to do anything yet until we've actually programmed it. So let's show you an example here. Now, I've got these doors, and if I hold down X, I can set a pin code for these doors. Now, I'm going to set the pin code as 5555 because that's easy to remember. You have to do any code that's 4 digits. It can be whatever you like. But for me, it's a lot easier to just punch the same number 4 times. So as you can see, these doors are closed, but if I hold X and hit activate slash open, and then punch in that same keypad, the door opens. And then I can actually do that for the other door too. Or I can deactivate slash close, hit 5555, and it will close again. If it's already closed and you tell it to close again, nothing happens. Same with if it's already opened. But we can punch in the different code that we set for that door to open that one. So that's the basics for programming your doors. Now I'm going to go ahead and close these two because they are blocking one way stuff can get up to this plateau base. But as you can see there, I tried to open it again and nothing happened. So I'll go ahead and close it. And there we go. Now in a minute, I'll show you how I set up my dinosaur taming pen with remote key codes. But before I do that, let me show you how to set up electric lighting on your remote keypad so we can turn all the lights on and off and set up different mood lighting. So first we'll grab this Tapehara egg, which was conveniently sitting in front of our base. This is so helpful. And we'll grab some snail cementing paste too on the way. Now I did a whole episode on how to set up lighting, and today we're going to show you how to turn it on and off really conveniently. So if we hold the X button on Switch, we can pull up that Set Pin Code option, and we can set the pin codes for both of our lights to channel 9999. And we've got the electric generator running. That's actually what's powering the keypad right now. We just extended the cable way down from this base. And hey, more snail poop. All right. That's a great substitute for cementing paste. Check out that video if you don't know what I'm talking about. So, we're gonna head back over to the keypad now that we have both lights set on the channel 9999, and you can set whatever channels help you to remember things. So we'll go ahead and deactivate this channel, and there we go, we punched in the 9999, and we'll head back to our base, and all of the lights will now be turned off. Now, you can use this to turn the whole lights on an entire compound on and off remotely. So if you've got lights all around your area, you can set them all on the same channel to instantly turn on and off whenever you need them. You can also set up different colors of lighting on different channels, so you can adjust the mood lighting to whatever you want, which is actually kind of cool and helpful. So we'll go ahead and turn all the lights back on, once again holding X, going to activate, and then hitting the code 9999. And all the lights are now back on in our base, and we'll be able to see. So that's going to save you a whole lot of time running around and turning lights on and off individually. So we'll be right back, and we'll show you how to set up auto turrets with a remote activation keypad. So you can have drone guns that you can activate from anywhere, even great distances away. Now I set up this little auto turret station pretty far away from my base. We're all the way across the river here, and I've got it hooked up to a generator, it's got electricity, and I put some ammo in its inventory. So we're gonna once again hold down X and set pin code, and I went ahead and programmed that to 0000, just cause that'll be easy to remember. And I almost forgot I need to change the targeting to wild creatures, so we can use this Triceratops as an example. He's just wandering around. Now, as you can see, the turret is actually deactivated, and if we turn it on, it's going to start shooting down that Triceratops. So we'll head back up to the base, and once we land, we're going to activate it from this remote keypad. Now, just like with all of the other electric items, we are going to run up to the keypad, hold down X, and select activate/open. Now we'll just punch in the key code, 4 zeros, and if I can get back up this hill quickly enough, we should be able to see what's happened down at the beach. So here we go, and let's see how that Triceratops is doing now that we've just activated the auto turret. And as you can see, he is almost instantaneously dead. So you can activate a turret from really far away. I could probably activate it all the way from the top of this mountain to my base and just mow down any nasty dinos that are around. So it's a really effective thing if you want to set up a perimeter of auto turrets. You can turn them on and off when you see a dino that you want them to get rid of, or you can allow them to stay off if there's dinos you don't want to kill. Also, if you're playing online and you have a friend come visit, you can instantly turn off all of your auto turrets, because the number one rule in hospitality on Ark is not killing your guests. Now, another cool feature that can save you some time is the last pin option. Now, if you want to turn something back off that you just turned on, you can click last number or show last pin, and that'll tell you what the last thing you punched in was. And if you hit that button, it's going to activate or deactivate the last thing that you just used. So that can save you a lot of time if you just want to turn something on and off. So I hope this concise guide on how to use a remote keypad in Ark was helpful, but I'm actually going to continue this episode to show you the Let's Play portion of how I'm actually using this to set up my dinosaur taming pen. And that will probably be pretty helpful for you too. But first I'm going to demolish this auto turret that I spawned in, because I don't normally use admin commands to spawn anything in. So I'll go ahead and demolish that and we'll get right back to it. Alright, so now on the Let's Play portion of this video, let me show you how I extended my electrical system all the way out to where we have that keypad. Because I only wanted to use one electrical generator. If you make a second one, which you can do, you don't need nearly as much electric cables, but you do need twice as much gasoline, and the generator itself takes a lot of materials. And electric cables are real cheap, they just require some metal. So I'm actually going to tack these on to the system that I've got in place, and somewhere around here, there we go, I actually left a connector that could extend out the wall of my base. Now I'm going to use a slanted cable here, an inclined electrical cable, which will bring that a little closer to the ground. Now, if I wanted to build this the easy way, I could put it right here, which would stay way above the ground, but it looks pretty dang ugly. So I'm going to bring these cables down much closer to the ground, and we'll extend it out from here. Now, you can actually place a couple of different connectors on either side of the incline, so that makes it a lot easier if you need to split your cables. But I'll keep extending this out, and it goes closer to the ground towards the edge of this cliff. cliff. Now, I'm going to show you some really cool tricks that we can use to make these cables look a lot prettier in just a second. Now, those of you who are still playing Ark on Switch are going to have to use the old-fashioned way to connect the cables, but those of us who have it on another console can make these flexible electrical cables, which are really helpful. They can actually connect two cables in just about any direction. Now, once we open up the fabricator, I'm going to make a whole bunch more straight cables because we just need to extend that cable out really far from the base. But the actual flexible cables are in their own folder, so right here is where you can find those flexible cables. They're in a different electrical folder than the one that all of the other electronics are under. I don't know, maybe just a glitch, but if you can't find your flexible electric cables, that's where you find them. So we're going to make a couple of these, and I'll show you how to use those in just a second. But basically, the way a flexible cable works is you can put down two cables that are not connected, and the flexible cable will allow you to make a connection between the two in any direction. So you can make your cables go at any angle, and you don't have to worry about making them line up properly. I also just made a whole bunch of gasoline because we are just about out, so let me bring this upstairs. So these ducts that are next to the electric generator are actually constantly laying Hesperornis eggs, which we can then cook into oil in the cooking pot and then refine into gasoline. And hey, more Tapehara eggs too. Means we can make some more really good kibble pretty soon. So let's run all the way out to the end of this cable here. There we go. And if we were building this normally, we'd have to make a right angle and it would just get really ugly. But what I'm going to do here is place this new cable right along the ground, right there, and it's actually going to clip into the slope. And now I can use the flexible cable, and as you can see, when I move this little dot around, it's going to snap to connect the two cables, even though they're at a really weird angle. Now another cool thing you can do is you can actually build electric cables into the ground. Now you may need to change your settings to enable clipping into the terrain. But all I can do here, if I look in the direction where that cable's going, it's going to snap to attach to the cable underground, even though I can't see it. But if I pull out my flexible cable, it's going to try to snap to the one underground, and it'll actually show me, it'll point directly to the end of the cable that's underground. So by doing it this way, I won't be able to pick these cables back up, but I can continuously extend these cables underground without messing up the landscaping. And you can have an entire cable running just a few feet below the surface. So let's see if I can find the end of this one. There we go. So the bottom of this little green dot is pointing straight to the end of that. So if I aim my screen about to that spot, it'll try to snap right there. Now I'm going to try to bring this back up to the surface because I want this to connect up there. So another flexible cable will allow me to bring it back up to the top. And that should be just about the level that I want this. So I'll be right back with some more supplies, and we're just going to keep extending this a little bit further. Now I've probably used like 30 cables to bring it out to here, but I would much rather use something like, I don't know, 60 metal than using a whole bunch of pearls to make the electronics I would need for another generator. So this is just about here, and one more run of cables. I've got this end of this cable underground, and I'm going to use my flexible cable to find it. There we go. And so I'm going to just drop one more straight cable right here, and we should be just about to where I need that electric outlet. And I think I'll make it actually hang out over the edge, and that should allow us to place the electric outlet within range of where I want to put that keypad. And that's going to put the keypad right where I can reach it really quickly at the top of this cliff after I lure a dinosaur into the dino taming pen. So now that I showed you how to set up the keypad, I'll show you how I programmed my dinosaur gates to trap dinos automatically. So I'm going to come down here and hold down the X button, and select set pin code, and we'll punch in 1111 to make this giant behemoth dinosaur gateway set on the channel for 1. And I'll fly back up there and show you how that works. So this way we're going to be able to lure dinos into this pen, and then we'll slam the door back behind them from a very safe distance up here. So we'll hold down X, go to open, and then hit 1111. And as you can see, this giant gate is now opening up behind us. And we can do the same thing in reverse to close that. So another thing I want to do is actually set up a little spot here that I can use to trap dinos. So let me clear this tree over here, and we're going to build a small taming pen in this area. I usually like to tame more than one dinosaur at the same time, and we're going to build a mini pen as a part of this taming pen that'll allow us to trap a smaller dino, and we can just drop that in with the Argent and tame it while we're taming something big. And having a little bit of walls to separate that will make it so we can do double tames without any trouble. Now, another slight modification I want to make is I'm going to add a wall right here that'll give a little corner that's going to trap dinos and make it much harder for them to accidentally wander out of this taming pen. I noticed when I was taming that Therizinosaurus that it kind of skated around the edge of the taming pen and then wandered back out through this spot right here, and most dinosaurs are probably going to do that. So if I can line this up properly without it snapping to that gateway, there we go, perfect. I'm adding just a little ledge which is going to actually trap dinos. So if they're running along the side here towards the door, that door is actually going to catch them and they'll get stuck right here, which should be enough time for me to close the door if they're heading out in that direction. So this should be pretty effective, and it's going to help us a lot. So let me show you this clip real quick of the Therizinosaur tame, and you can see right there he just ran right out the door along the edge. But if I had this new little thing there, it'll actually block that from happening next time I tame something. So that should be pretty helpful. So now I'm actually going to build this little container here. It'll just be a little chamber of our taming pen. And you can build as many of these as you want, but for me, I'm just going to make one little mini pen inside the big pen. And this should actually make it so I can trap some smaller dinos. And of course, it's always really difficult to lay dinosaur gateways because they try to clip into the other gateways that are nearby. But I should be able to get this to work, and we'll have a nice little mini taming pen, and that's going to be really helpful when I am bored taming up a dinosaur that is just taking a really long time. That Therizinosaurus took forever to tame, and I just kind of had to hang around the base, so I was really wishing I could tame a smaller dino at the same time. But you've always got the risk, if you're taming a bigger dino, that if you have a smaller dino in that taming pen, the smaller one could actually kill the bigger one while it's unconscious. And if the big one wakes up, it could kill the smaller one. So it's good to have walls separating them, unless you're just into doing gladiator-style dinosaur battles, which, I mean, you know, cool if you want to. So that looks pretty good. We got our mini dino taming pen here. And I'm going to code all of the doors to the code 2222. And anytime we need to let a dino out of there or try to trap one in, we can control these doors separately from the other ones. And it's really helpful if you use multiple different codes to do different sections of your doors. And we'll probably actually color code these later using a spray painter. That'll be pretty fun. I'll show you how to do that in the near future. And I'm also going to set all of the outer doors to a separate pin code. We'll go 6666 on this one. And that way, if I just need to let a dino out of the pen, like say a dino that I don't want ends up wandering in on accident, then I can just swing all of the doors open, and then it suddenly no longer has walls on the outside, and it'll be real easy to get a dino out of here. So that'll give us complete control of the entire dino taming pen and all of the walls right from that little keypad up on top of the cliff. So it's going to be a really good, efficient system, and that should make things much easier for us. So there we go. And I'm going to code these last two doors. And this other door on the side, I don't know if I really need to worry about. It's just kind of barely there. Well, I guess I'll do that. Okay. So now we've got all of the doors coded. And I'll show you how those work in just a second. So we'll head back up to the top of the cliff here, and now we can actually use the keypad. So now we've got this dino taming pen set up with all of the doors coded to the keypad. So I'll hold down X and I can activate open or deactivate close. And then whichever code I punch in, it's going to open up that particular door. So there is the giant doorway right there, which is the main one we're going to be using. We'll mostly just be opening and slamming that one shut behind other dinos. But we can also open up the smaller pen, and if it's a dino that doesn't fit in our Argent, we can still get it to run into that smaller area and then lock it in there for another double tame. And then if we want to just let everything out, we just punch in the 6 code, and that opens up the entire pen and lets anything out right away. So no matter what the circumstance is for the rest of the game, we will be in great shape to tame anything at all, and we can tame more than one at a time. So I hope this was really helpful for you. If it was, please be sure to like this video and drop a comment if you have any questions about anything that we covered or any advice for me or other people. A lot of you know so much about Ark, and you're teaching me things all the time. And I'd love to hear if you use keypads in your base on Ark and what you use them for. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do so and be sure to ring that bell for notifications, because we release all kinds of great helpful Ark guides, and usually there's a new video every couple of days, so you definitely want to know when those come out. And if you want to watch more videos that I'm in, my wife and I have a new YouTube channel called The Console Co-op Couple, and there will be a link in the description where you can watch lots of videos where the two of us play Switch games together. It's a whole lot of fun, and I hope you'll check that out. It would mean a lot to us if you subscribe over there too. So until next time, I hope you have a great time on your own Ark adventures, and we'll see you in the next video. Also, in the end of this video, there will be a link to my Ark Switch Survival Guide series, and it has an entire video on everything that I've done so far in this adventure. And if there's anything you don't understand, or you see anything that I've built that you want to know about, there's a video in that list that'll teach you all about it and show you how I built it. So be sure to check that out too. And until next time, I hope your adventures are safe and fun, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.